Okay, once again, I got up a little bit earlier and did some practice with the lockpick, watched a couple of tutorials, like instructionary videos and whatever. Might come in handy. Maybe I'll give the TV a go before I go outside.
American citizens are among the missing. The Incarn sarcophagus delivered to the Los Angeles Museum of Natural History this morning was stolen just hours before experts could examine its contents. Authorities are baffled by its theft, as the museum employs several sophisticated security measures that have foiled previous robbery attempts. Police
speculate the
user behind the sarcophagus's disappearance.
That's interesting.
More on the story as it breaks. A tourist bus destined for the ancient city of Angkor Wat that failed to return Wednesday night was found this
morning, that already
without any trace
in one
of
the previous auditions.
Passengers. Cambodian officials have dispatched several military units into the area to search through the surrounding jungle amidst concerns that it is related to one of a number of Southeastern Asian terrorist organizations based in the region. Three American citizens are among the missing. Concerned parent groups joined several senators on the step of Capitol Hill to protest the latest wave of violent video games. Senator Wimperman called the games pornography and was offended by crude shots taken at him by one recent game. Among the titles the group is trying to get banned from stores are Mangle Garden, Rape and Pillage, and Abe Lincoln Teaches Killing. Protesters and extended media attention towards games such as Meth Tycoon promotes parental awareness of their adult content and lessen children's interest in the taboo-themed games. Religious tourists have been flocking in droves to the Santa Maria Church in Santiago, Spain, after several pilgrims claim to have seen statues of the Madonna begin crying blood. The site dates back to the period of the Romans and has several reported weeping virgin sightings throughout its history.
Yeah, but I guess no video.
Reported that they witnessed blood coming from
there never is.
Six statues at around sunset, and that the courtyard felt full of sadness. Skeptics have been quick to point out that this phenomena has been debunked, and witnesses are no more credible than those that report UFOs. The Southland Slasher struck again, this time in downtown Los Angeles. The body of Sean Duncan,
I think
a former convict,
some of those are running on repeat from the previous auditions, so I guess that's it. Something to do at the Hollywood Cemetery, searching the grave of that actress, Ginger Swan or something?
Hop in.
Yeah, to Hollywood, please. I swear that sounded like his zombie or something. Like a moan. Okay, I guess I should be on the lookout for the ginger swan person. Yeah, I swear I hear like moaning. Andrew mates. Chad. Seems to be like a home in the middle of the cemetery. Maybe it's like a groundkeeper's home. Maybe I'll ask him, but provided he isn't asleep. After all, it's a little late. Hello? Good evening, sir.
Oh, there, Slick. Might want to think about knocking next time I damn near blew your head off. Thought you might be a zombie.
Well, I did knock, and anyway, why would you think I was a zombie?
Who else would be waltzing in here in the middle of the night? Name's Romero. I'm the caretaker here. Well, that is, I don't exactly keep people from getting in, although that is part of my job. No, you see, I'm here to make sure nothing gets out.
I have an awful suspicion I know what you're talking about, but still. What do you mean, exactly?
See, it's like this. Every night around this time for the past, several months now, the dead have been getting up with an itch to stroll down Hollywood Boulevard. Nobody knows why, but they're working on it. Till they figure it out, they needed a volunteer to patch the problem, and I stepped forward. Problem temporarily solved, the Baron's happy, I get to shoot zombies, and guarantee I get my blood for a month. I've carved out a nice niche here.
Oh, so you're a ghoul. Like, actually, as weird as that may sound, I've encountered zombies before, or at least zombie-like creatures. But what do you figure is the cause of that? What causes them to rise?
Who knows? Vampire necro voodoo, toxic waste, solar radiation. The important part is they continue to rise up, and I get to put them down. Everybody's a winner.
Right. Sounds like fun.
You're telling me. As far as I know, I'm the only person around Hollywood who considers marksmanship an art. A lot of the stiffs around here used to be asshole celebrities, too. Bonus. I love my job. What can I say? By the way, hey, you wouldn't be interested in watching the place while I go handle some business, would you? I'm not supposed to leave, or it might end up in a zombie holocaust or something. Like one time these goths snuck in. Ooh, wasn't pretty.
What would I have to do?
I'll be back in about 5 minutes. If you should see any zombies in that time, you need to put them down. Now, they're dead, so you're either going to hack them up good, or shoot them in the head. Just don't let them bite you.
Not really interested in fighting zombies, like, not really that great at it. Maybe I can help you some other way?
Well, I don't know. What are you thinking?
Well, I don't know. What kind of business do you need to take care of? Maybe I can, you know, run some errands for you?
Sometimes a man needs the kind of release putting a 44 slug through a zombie's brain doesn't. You're a guy, you understand, right?
Oh. I get it. I'll bring something back for you. Like a, you know, lady of the night or whatever.
Really? You will? Great. I'll just stay here and keep watch. Oh, and FYI, I like them a little, you know, stacked. Appreciate it.
I'll be back soon. So now I guess the only thing I've got to do is convince some escort to come. come down here. Maybe he'll be helpful. It's always good to make some friends, and anyway, not going to hurt anyone. Unless he's like a crazy serial killer and he's going to kill her. In which case, I would be kind of bummed. So I really hope it won't happen. But if it doesn't, then... well, she can get paid, he can get laid, and everybody's happy, right? Now just to find him a suitable... She seems to be busy. What's the news lately? Imagine that. Exchange faces. What? Okay. Guess I will have to do some more looking around to find a suitable. Excuse me, ma'am.
Hey, baby. Looking for a date?
Yeah, I am, but not for me. For a friend of mine.
Okay, I'll play along. Where's this friend of yours?
Okay, that's going to... Well, he's the caretaker of the cemetery.
Oh, no way am I going in there. What kind of freak are you?
I assure you, you'll be perfectly safe.
I don't know why I should believe you. Well, okay. But I'm gonna get really pissed if you turn out to be some psycho murderer. Let's go.
Well, it's not me you got to worry about, but if that makes you feel any better, if he turns out to be a psycho murderer, then I'll be pretty pissed at that too. Hey, listen, the gate is closed this time of night, so we'll have to do a little... acrobatics. But I assure you, he's going to compensate you. Just go through here. You following? Where is she? Did she somehow run ahead of me? How would that even be possible? Well, maybe she vaulted over the wall or whatever. Maybe she's secretly a superhero or something. Is she there?
Hey, very nice.
Oh, I guess
what
she
can I
is.
Give you for the assist?
Actually, you said you're like an expert marksman, right? So maybe you can help me, you know, improve my skill with firearms. You know, give me a couple of lessons or something.
When you fire, keep your eyes on the target even after you shoot. And use the sight. That's what it's there for. And style doesn't count for jack if you can't hit anything. Keep that Glock to the side crap in the movies. Oh, enjoy the time. Me and, girl here got some couch Olympics to compete in, so if you don't mind.
Yeah, sure. Enjoy yourself. Well, he didn't exactly tell me anything about the ginger swans, but still was kind of... useful. Okay, I'm really getting spooked by this place, so I better look for the ginger swans and get out before I get eaten by a zombie or something. My memories with them aren't really the best. Okay, this is some kind of mausoleum. Maybe she's in there. After all, she was supposed to be like a famous person. That's it, right. Devil's Pawn, Flesh Fist, and the logo DMP. Well, that's what I came for. Better get out. This place is giving me the heebie-jeebies. Okay, that's not the way. For a second, I thought that tree was like a person, and I got really startled. Well, that's what I wanted. Sounds like a zombie. And I guess at this point, I know for a fact that there are zombies around here, so. Evening.
Don't have it, do you?
I actually do have it.
I didn't doubt you'd find this, and I apologize if I was overly imperious before. A reflex action. I get a lot of young blood in here for getting their place. I'll assist you as reasonably as I can with your task. But first, this tape. I'm in a hurry to find out what's behind all the hype, so get comfortable. I do have a feeling that whatever's here may be of use to both of us.
Whoa, what the hell is that? Man, that is some top-notch special effects there. Wow, that, damn it, freak. That did look pretty realistic. Although I was never a big fan of horror movies, so. I'm not sure.
It's more disturbing than I was led to believe. You can understand my concern now, can't you?
Well, that was kinda sick. If it was true anyway, why did you show that to me?
It just so happens that around the time this snuff film started circulating, the Nosferatu disappeared. I tried to elicit their help in tracking down the source, and for the first time in all these years, I was dismayed by their absence.
How do you usually contact them, actually?
Usually, I just put the word out I'm looking for them, and sooner or later, they appear.
Right, that's pretty Nosferatu of them. So, you think this tape has something to do with their disappearance?
I assume it does. It's awfully coincidental otherwise. And those creatures. I don't know how many professional FX houses could pull those off. There's a problem, though, in that the film's incomplete. The first half is damaged. We need a complete copy.
Well, so how do you find that, exactly?
Behind the spit-shine gloss of the Hollywood Dream Factory, there's another city churning out a vile byproduct for the furtive consumption of a debauched audience. I have no doubt the film's found its way to another smut peddler. I'd ask around.
Well, I actually do have a few questions before I go.
Certainly.
Tell me something about yourself, if you can.
In your lifetime, unwittingly or not, you have seen an Isaac Abrams production. As the financier of 30% of American film's top 100 movies, you must have. Being the Baron of Hollywood, I can do any project I want.
I see. Who's your favorite person that you've worked with?
Stewart, Lean, Hitchcock, Wilder, Holden, Dean, Scorsese, De Niro,
last but not least, long list of names.
My child. I remember some studio suit lost in time telling me the only thing they could use Bogart for was to move furniture.
You mentioned Ash?
Ash. Where do I begin? 7 years ago, I saw a casting session for what would become Negative Zero. The moment I set eyes on him, the passion in his performance, I knew he had it.
Well, do go on.
I hadn't seen anything like him since Clift or Dean. He had the looks, the charisma, the lure, that undefinable quality that makes a film legend. My first movie with him made him a sensation, and it also changed him.
How did it change him exactly?
Once everyone knew who he was, I no longer did. The parties, the drinking, the sports cars, the women. One night, when I came to discuss his next role, I found him nearly dead of an overdose. And I couldn't let him go.
So, you embraced him to save him?
I acted on impulse. I'd seen so many others die before their time, but with Ash, I had a chance to prevent that fate.
So, what happened next? I can't imagine he was too thrilled with that. I probably wouldn't be.
It devastated Ash.
Yeah.
He still wanted to act, but I denied him his place in the limelight. He had to lie to his friends about his new lifestyle. He had to feed. I gave him a club, a scrap of his former glory. I did everything I could to facilitate the change.
So, do you think he hates you?
He feels obligated to me. I don't think he hates me. Resents me, maybe. I am his sire, and he is my child. There is a responsibility and respect inherent in that bond, even if we are no longer the friends we were.
I see. Where I can find him, in case I wanted to talk or something?
He spends nearly all of his nights in his club, the Asp Hall. I admit it, too old-fashioned to appreciate it. To me, it's the compressed essence of everything that's wrong with the film industry today.
I see. Maybe I'll head over there sometime. But I have a couple of other questions.
Certainly.
So, what can you tell me about the Nosferatu and your relation with them?
The Nosferatu? I pity them, but I loathe their presence. I deal with them when it's necessary. I know they're beneath my city somewhere, but only they know where. They respect my streets, and I keep my politics out of their sewers. But I don't trust them by any stretch of the word.
I see.
Certainly.
Anything else I can do around the city?
There is something, but it involves a gargoyle. I can see that's got your attention.
Yeah, tell me about this gargoyle.
It's taken up residence in my beloved Asian theater. It is closed now, but that's beside the point. I sent some people to evict it, and it sent them back with a few less limbs. I can't have that monster attacking kindred in my city.
Well, I'm interested, but how exactly does one deal with a gargoyle? I'm not even 100% sure I know what it is.
It's a walking block of stone with a taste for blood. I'd suggest whatever method doesn't result in you being eviscerated. In truth, I'd rather have it as an ally, but I doubt it's going to be chatty. Here's the key for the theater. I'll leave it up to you.
Okay, I'll see what I can do. I'll be back eventually. So there are actually a couple of things to do around here. Man, those two are too close for me to save the feed on either of them. I think I will leave the theater be for now. Maybe try and find some more information about that gargoyle. Maybe I will ask Strauss. He seems to know a lot, so maybe he knows something about gargoyles as well. Yeah, and there was this smart peddler, like a sex shop or something, right around here. Maybe I'll ask him about the tape. Yeah, whatever it's called, the sin bin. Good evening.
Hey, Slick.
Yeah, hey. Who are you?
The name's Flynn. I'm the proprietor of this here establishment. Anything you want, you can get at the sin bin. Depraved ain't a four-letter word here. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. I have a few questions for you.
Yeah? What do you want to know?
Well, tell me about this place, at first.
The sin bin? Man, we've got filth of every flavor. Just tell me what makes your bits tingle, Jack. I'll set you right up.
Well, I'm not really interested in most of that anymore. I mean, most of that for now. But...
Yeah? What do you want to know?
Did you ever hear about something called Death Mask Productions?
Those guys? Yeah, I heard of them. Why do you want to know?
I might be in the market for some of their products.
Really? You a cop?
No, I'm just trying to get some info. I'm a connoisseur, if you will.
All right, listen. I'll tell you a little bit, but if anyone comes asking, you never heard it from me. They produce only the most hardcore video. I'm not even talking black market here, more like black hole market. Not the kind of product you want to get mixed up in.
I see. So, what kind of stuff exactly?
Kind of stuff that gets you put in jail for just talking about it, all right? Snuff films is just the tip of the iceberg. I only seen one of their videos, and I swear I couldn't eat for a week.
Well, so do you think the stuff in their videos is real?
Real enough that every cop in five states has been trying to track these guys down.
Oh.
They are bad news, pal. You want some advice from me? Stop thinking whatever you're thinking and get your ass back to Kansas.
Yeah, listen. I really need to find those guys. Do you have any directions?
Forget it, man. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. Huh? What? Who are they? Seriously, get the hell out of here.
Listen, I'm, as I said, a connoisseur of sort. You can tell me. I'm not going to share that information with anyone, let alone the police.
Okay. Look, all I know is that a guy calls on the payphone down the street every once in a while. He'll say something like, the moon is a terrible mistress, or some creepy shit like that.
Yeah, and then what?
And then all you have to say is, who walks the night with demons of dread? Supposedly you'll be told where to meet the guy to pick up product. I don't know for sure. I never tried it. It scared the shit out of me.
Yeah, thanks. I'm out of here.
Hey, wait. Look, you might as well know this. Word on the street is that they didn't even make the video. They're just distributing it. No one even knows where it comes from. I'm telling you, man, whatever you're in, get out of it now.
I wish I could, but I think I'm in it for good. See ya. Well, I'm not really about to browse the merchandise. Not really into it, although some of those magazines have caught my eye. We've got doggies, greed, pain and suffering, and chin. What the? Woman whaler? Worm? That's some interesting selection, and that's not even the porn. Chin shop? There's chin and there is chin shop. World War... Thane, Faker's Quarterly. That's an interesting selection. Was never much into that kind of stuff, even back then, and now even less titillating than it was. There's somebody getting murdered in here every night, so maybe it shouldn't surprise me as much. Yeah, but I'll go and ask Strauss if he knows anything about the gargoyle.
Going somewhere.
Yeah, downtown. Well, actually, now that I'm here, and I'm not hungry, maybe I can, you know, browse the stuff they've got here. I don't recognize any of those titles. And some of them are even in languages I don't know. What about this book here? Thaumaturgical creatures. Gargoyles, well. Conflict with the, however you read it, blood magic, and created a race of protectors known as gargoyles. Scouts, warriors, and sentries. Created by vampires. Blood and flesh through which they are created. Yeah, I wouldn't be that skeptical about calling it slavery. It very much seems to be slavery. They basically created them to be servants. So I better not mention the fact that I'm a Tremere to that gargoyle. Homunculi. Wait, winged, many-legged, man, what is it? Okay, so that's some info on the gargoyles. At the very least, I know that I shouldn't tell him I'm a Tremere, but still, it's probably best if I asked Strauss what he thinks about it, especially now that I know the gargoyles have been created by the Tremere, so I have no doubt he knows much about the subject. Good evening, Regent. I need to talk with you.
Hello, Neonate. How can I be of assistance?
Do we have a moment to talk?
Of course.
I have a question for you about gargoyles.
Gargoyles? Why are you asking about gargoyles?
Well, it seems that one lives in the old theater in Hollywood, and I have some questions about it.
What can I tell you about them?
Well, first, what exactly is a gargoyle?
A gargoyle, put simply, is a creature that was created to protect the Tremere clan in the early years of our existence. They are very powerful, and not to be trifled with.
So the Tremere created them?
Yes. We used our extensive knowledge of blood magics to create a race of protectors. They served that purpose well, but they have also caused many problems. It's a complicated issue.
Well, how complicated is it really?
Well, many gargoyles still serve the Tremere masters, but a number of them have since rebelled and gone into hiding. They are a sentient race, but ultimately unfit for the freedom they desire. They need the guidance of their former masters.
Well, if you say so, but you sound like you have some personal experience in this matter.
Yes. I know something of gargoyles, and of this gargoyle in particular. I had hoped that he would meet his final death, but it seems my creation still lives to torment me.
Wait, so you created it?
Yes. Many years ago, I created this gargoyle to protect the Chantry from our enemies. He was a faithful servant, and saved my life more than once. Unfortunately, he became increasingly upset about his role as my protector, and wished to be set free. I refused to do so. Finally, he stole away into the night, and I haven't seen him since.
Well, actually, Isaac Abrams has asked me to get rid of the gargoyle.
Isaac Abrams? His disrespect for the Camarilla is surpassed only by his hatred of LaCroix. If he finds out, it will be a source of great embarrassment for the clan and the Camarilla. He cannot learn that this gargoyle was my creation. Do you understand?
Completely. I will protect the secrets of the clan.
Ah, I see that you've learned well. Despite the indiscretions of your sire, you are proving to be an asset for the clan. I commend and thank you, Neonate.
Yeah, so what should I do now? How do I take it down?
Here, take this. It is an ancient ward that may help you on your battle with the gargoyle. You need only carry it on your person to enjoy its protection.
Thanks, but how does one best fight a creature like that?
With much difficulty, I'm afraid. Gargoyles are notoriously resilient. Their hides are made of stone. Firearms will be almost useless.
Damn it.
Blunt force is the only thing they understand.
So, like a... sledgehammer or something. Okay, can you tell me anything more?
What can I tell you about them?
Well, I guess...
Of course.
I guess we've talked enough. So, I'll be back when I deal with the problem. Have a good night, Regent. Well, he said firearms would be useless, and I have no reasons not to believe him, so I think I will give Fat Larry a visit and maybe see if he has any weapons that might be more suitable for the task. Got something for me?
Money, right? Come back in a few nights. I'll have another ward for you.
Great. So I guess nothing for now. Still, it was worth checking. To do some shopping. Well, he's got an axe, so that may be useful, but I would like something even more blunt. Yeah, I don't think try to hunt near the club, like in an alleyway on the side or something. Behind the old shop, the shops and whatnot. Did that just move on itself? This place is a little too crowded. Check behind the gas station. At the convenience store, but I've seen weirder in this town, so might as well check.
The moon is out, everyone's in dreamland, and you've tuned into the dead of night. Nobody to fall asleep next to? Go ahead and pull the radio.
Cigarette smoking can cause,
and hey, why don't you
may lead to death of cute little puppies, says the Surgeon General, apparently. Good evening.
Looks like somebody's been waiting in the queue quite a while to speak to yours truly.
Welcome to Red Spot.
So called
Old Monster Chart. 72 ounces of your favorite beverage for 89 cents.
Insects.
Blah, blah. Do you need help or something?
You have an insect problem? Or chirping crickets?
Yeah.
Or you have nightmares about
anything exciting going on here?
No, no. Don't you
always. You should come out and see my band, Ball of Syria. We're playing
tomorrow
at
the
crematorium. $5, two drink in. We're gonna ruin the place.
What can you do?
Are there any scientists?
Okay, anything else I should know about?
I read something.
Yeah,
I don't know where.
Vesuvius rocks.
Do you know the average person needs several pounds of insects a year? The majority of that weight is composed of roaches, ants, and spiders.
What does that even mean? Anyway, maybe I'll check it out, but...
Hey, you know, you should really ask me about the special, you know?
I never sleep at night.
You know, they voluntarily eat insects.
Okay, so...
Yeah,
what is the special?
I'm glad you asked that,
so,
bro.
So, you never
Seeing
sleep at night.
Like,
I assume you do sleep, right?
I got this special.
I sleep at work.
And what exactly do you do?
I'm a middle school teacher.
That would explain why my nephew invested that
$20
on magic beans.
That's a good
it's
deal.
Good to know that the future of our country
sure, show me what he got.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
Let's see who else we got. Caller, what do you do for a living?
And that might come in handy.
Okay, and what do you do, Roger?
I'm a writer, Deb.
I don't think
so
I have anything
written
to
any
sell.
Movies I might have seen?
But still.
Well,
I'll take that. I haven't
finished any screenplays yet.
Sledgehammer,
I see.
Please.
So, have you done any other kinds of writing?
Well, just some outlines
and
right now.
You know what?
I've got some really good ideas for some stories that are crawling around in the old noggin.
So, if you haven't really
how
written anything,
ammo?
How can you call yourself a writer? Because I once fixed my toilet doesn't make me a plumber, right?
Okay, for the glove.
Is there anyone in this city that doesn't call themselves a writer or actor or director?
Okay, that's all.
Hola.
Thanks, it was really nice. Actually, did you hear anything new about the serial killer?
This isn't going to turn out to be ironic, is it? You're not like a serial killer, are you?
Anyone else agrees? Line two.
No. So I guess you didn't hear anything new.
I'm a personal assistant.
Well, anyway, it was nice talking to you and doing business.
Don't get me started.
Well, for our writer on the phone.
Well, imagine that. I actually bought a sledgehammer at a convenience store. So now I should be ready to deal with this gargoyle, whichever way it goes. First, I need to find it, but if I do, I'll try to talk to it. Contrary to what I told Strauss, I very much empathize with it to a degree. Like, it seems iffy, the whole business with, you know, them getting created just to serve the Tremere. I can understand it being pissed about it. And if I can convince it to just, you know, stop gnawing on random people and eating them, then... maybe I can let it be and then just, you know, bullshit Strauss and tell him that I killed it or something. I've gotten quite good at bullshitting people lately. So, now I just need to find it. Whoa! What's that? Whoa! I guess it found me first. You know, just talking. I'm not here to fight you.
Talk? No. Always kindred are talking, scheming, hurting others with their lies. Monsters you all. Abominations. A curse upon the earth.
Okay, better better not mention Strauss to him. I have an offer from Isaac Abrams.
Offer? What offer? Yet another lie? He hopes to control me, to enslave me, just as my master before him. First he sends his underlings to destroy me, and now he wants to make peace. No! Curse him! Curse you all!
Listen, he doesn't want to control you. He actually wants you to help him. He needs your protection.
What is this? Another devilish trick? Am I to trade one chain for another? Bow to Abrams now, instead of my old master? Never!
Isaac, he doesn't need a servant. He needs an ally against the Camarilla.
Camarilla? What means this, Camarilla?
Well, the Camarilla are kindred who want to rule over other kindred. Isaac, he fights against them. And actually, the Tremere, your old masters, they're part of the Camarilla. And Isaac opposes them.
He fights against his own kind.
Yeah, as I said, he fights against those who, well, made you their slave, against the Tremere.
The Tremere. Hate them above all your kind, I do. Secrecy and sorcery, betrayal and blood magic. Damn to hell all of you, but the Tremere most of all.
Well, I totally agree, and Isaac, he needs your help to fight them.
Yes, I will fight alongside this Abrams and help him in his battle against this Camarilla, lifeless demon he may be, but I swear to fight at his side.
Great. So just, you know, try to not eat random people and stuff. I'll go tell Isaac that this issue has been dealt with.
Yes. Now leave me. This theater is my domain, and I seek the peace of solitude.
Okay, I'm leaving. Okay. Well, that went better than expected, although it might cause some complications down the road if Strauss ever learned that I let it live, but still, as much as I'd like to garner favor with the clan Tremere, I really do pity the guy a little. And the gargoyles as a whole, their existence, what they did to them, doesn't really seem right. And I guess Strauss doesn't need to know. See through me, though, would be a most uncomfortable meeting if he does. Good evening.
Any luck?
I've dealt about with the gargoyle. I actually convinced it to help you in your fight against the Camarilla.
A gargoyle serving in the defense of Hollywood. Exceptional. I'm sure it'll come as quite a surprise to the first shock troop that crosses the city line. You've got a lot of promise. It's a shame you're still working full-time for the wrong side.
I actually got nothing against the Anarchs.
I'd like to hope so. Well, if you'll excuse me.
Well, see you later. Guess it's back to Strauss. Mother? I will check out this club. Aspol, was it? That's run by Isaac's child. Yeah, I think I'll do that before I go. See if maybe this Ash has something interesting to say about his sire. Because that's the last call. Whoa, that's an interesting getup. Man, he looks like a guy I killed sometime earlier. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, any of you? Would you like to move? Actually, an interesting thing is, how would I even recognize Ash? Excuse me, can I help you?
Sun's gone down.
Yeah, he does that a lot. Actually, are you Ash?
Present.
It's nice to meet you. I've heard some about you.
I bet.
Man, what's your problem? You really have a shitty attitude.
Sun's gone down.
Yeah, as I said, it does that a lot, so
never mind.
Man, you really are a tough one to talk to.
Me neither.
Listen, just tell me what's the problem.
What's the catch?
That's what I'm asking. Do you have a death wish or something? Are you always this annoying?
To say yes would be an understatement.
Oh.
I wouldn't care anymore. I could just do it. Just walk out of here and do it. Maybe I live, maybe I don't. What's the difference?
So, what exactly are you talking about besides your suicidal thoughts?
You didn't see them?
See who exactly?
Hunters and fun guys inside my club. I try to leave them. So I had to ask myself, if I go out there, am I prepared to die? How many could I take out before the killing stroke, huh? Two. Three.
Oh, so that's who the guy
right now. Blaze of glory, the end. And you know what? No one might. It doesn't bother me. And I guess the only reason I haven't walked out yet is because I'm trying to figure out why it doesn't bother me.
Listen, maybe I can help you. I've dealt with hunters before.
Did Isaac send you?
Well, I guess he kinda did.
Forget it. I don't need his help. Tell him he can sit in his own office and chew on his charity.
No, listen, he didn't send me, he just mentioned you, and I came here on my own volition.
What the hell, man, would be your motivation to help me?
Well, I try to help people in general, and you do seem to need help.
And what do you propose we do?
I could, escort you out through the sewers, and if we have to fight, well, I'd hate to, but I have some experience.
Sure about that? I don't know that you even out the odds a whole lot, but just maybe we'll make it out alive. Are you ready right now?
Yeah, actually, let's just do it.
If I make it past the hunters, I'm getting the hell out of town. Let's head into the sewers.
Okay, I'll follow you. Listen, you just stay back and try not to get killed. Flavor to them. Weird but good. Keep back. You know what? Just wait here and I'll scout ahead. Not getting involved, didn't you? Ow.
I lost.
Part didn't you understand? Man, you really do have a death wish.
Yeah.
I guess follow me if you must. Anything in here? Seems to be some kind of an office or something. How about this place? An entrance. It's probably best to check this tunnel first. Seems to be way forward through here. You just wait. I'll see what I can... Whoa! Man, that did that guy compact. I guess I can... take that. Not going to hurt, that's for sure. But what did kill him? It doesn't look like a... To be honest, it looks like a wound. Taken from a beast. Like a Nosferatu with claws or something? I don't think it was the hunters anyway. Well, was a detour, but quite worthwhile actually.
Yeah.
Take cover. not just run ahead. If you wanted to kill yourself, you should have done it on your own time. Now you have me, so better not embarrass me by dying. I would kind of feel bad about it, but it would still be your fault. Doing? Are you insane? Man, he really does have a death wish. Calm down. If you want to burn, then just go outside when it's daylight. Okay, now we're going back to you, of course. I feel like you're acting up, to be entirely honest. Listen, just come with me, but try to stay back. Safe now. Come on. Can't you operate a ladder, golden boy? Come on, you coming? God, what's wrong with you? Apart from, you know, everything. Yeah, thanks. Good luck in your future endeavors, whatever they might be.
It was as far as I could fall. It was as low as I could go. Way past oblivion to a point only described as negative zero.
That was a little pretentious, but anyway, good luck. I will go to... Well, first I need to go to Strauss. And try to spin him some bullshit about the gargoyle. I really hope he's not going to see through me, because if he does, my existence may be woefully short. Oh. Good evening, Regent.
Hello, neonate. How can I be of assistance?
I have something to talk about.
Of course.
I've resolved the issue with the gargoyle.
You did? That's quite an accomplishment for one so young, neonate. And with discretion as well.
Of course.
Again, you impress me.
I'm just doing what I feel is right.
And your efforts are well appreciated. Please accept this gift as payment for your accomplishment. The Tremere clan appreciates your confidentiality.
Like I said, I'm trying to do best with the clan.
Yes, indeed. You have more than proven yourself, and I have spoken of you to my lord. He and I both agree that you would be a great asset to the clan.
Oh? What do you mean exactly?
It means that you are welcome to join the Chantry as an apprentice. As a result, you will live here in a room of your own and enjoy the luxury and privacy it affords you. Do you accept this honor, neonate?
Of course I do. Thank you, Regent.
I knew that I was right about you. Welcome to the pyramid, my apprentice. Your things have already been moved from your haven in Santa Monica. They're upstairs waiting for you.
Thank you. It's very nice of you. Nice to be part of the clan, finally. Although, I can't seem to wonder what he would have done if I declined. Still, I feel I've earned a powerful ally. Maybe even against LaCroix at some point, because I seem to remember Strauss here talking with some, you know, rather critically about LaCroix at one point. Obviously he's loyal to the Camarilla as a whole, but as far as his loyalties to the prince go, mine now. Wow, that's a great place. The shower still looks kind of dirty, but besides that, certainly it's a step above my apartment in Santa Monica. Some books. Oh, and some kind of talisman. Guess I'm going to take it. I've got a shining new PC as well. Have a nice day still. Ah, of course I need to log in on a different machine. No new emails, it seems, so I guess I'll see if there's something new on the radio.
The moon is out, everyone's in dreamland, and you've tuned into the dead of night. Nobody to fall asleep next to?
Nah, I think it's...
Hold the radio into bed, that's what I'm here for.
I think it's another rerun.
Hey, why don't you call me sometime? Area code 323-KL5-KTRK. Looks like somebody's been waiting in the queue quite a while to speak to yours truly. So caller, why aren't you asleep?
Insects.
Yeah, right. Another rerun. Anyway, I'll probably go to bed. Certainly a nicer looking bed than the last one was. So, we'll see. How well will I sleep? What the next night will bring.